sports is something that has existed in every human society once people have had the ability to clothe themselves, to provide shelter for themselves, and to feed themselves. And so sports becomes an outgrowth of a functioning society. And you fast forward to 2020, we are not a functioning society in the United States. And you see that reflect itself in the world of sports. But the bigger picture is that sports reflects whatever economic system it exists under, whether feudalism, hunter-gatherer societies, and of course, capitalism, to get to your question. And under capitalism, we've seen sports become a big business. The game is not just to be played, the game is to be sold to as wide an audience as possible. And I think the people who first started sports, as we developed as a capitalist society, certainly in the United States, in their wildest dreams could not have envisioned the kind of global leviathan that the sports world has become, a trillion-dollar entity that reaches into every corner of the earth. And so sports is big business. And because it's big business, all kinds of issues that exist under capitalism, whether issues regarding labor, social movements, struggle, fights for equity, they all not just reflect themselves in the world of sports, but the world of sports then shapes those battles off the field and in broader sectors of society. So I think it does us a great disservice when we try to de-link the big business of sports from how capitalism is existing and developing in our society. Sports is capitalism and capitalism is sports.
How do you feel about the argument that making money or profit is somehow shaping literally the sports we have, the sports contests, the development of young people as they mature into being athletes? How do you see the impact of the business side of it shaping the other sides of it?
Well, I think it warps youth sports, to take it through the line. Youth sports over the last generation has become a big business unto itself. It's become a feeder system into the colleges and into the pros. And this is a relatively recent development, this idea of seeing youth sports as a profit center and not just a place where young people gather to play. So you've seen the way capitalism has distorted youth sports to a pretty profound degree. And one of the ways it distorts youth sports is that it creates a value system that says only people who can play should play. And if you're not a good athlete, the best you can be is a watcher, is a spectator, is somebody who looks at the people who can play, play. And it's hard to think of something more warped than that, this idea of when you take sports and kids, which should be a site of fun and fair play and community and developing friendship, to see it become something that just mirrors professional sports. So that's the way it's warped youth sports. And by the way, a statistic that I find very troubling is that somewhere it's estimated between 60 and 70% of young kids quit playing sports by the age of 13. And that's a terrible thing. I mean, it relates to young people's health. It relates to how they're able to function during their teenage years. And it's all because of this value system that's projected onto the world of sports.